Hello everybody, this is Carlos from Army of Nurses and welcome to another video. Today's video I'm going to show the instructors how to access HSP-NET in order to get a list of your students. So learning objective will be instructor will be able to identify and recognize sections and components of the HSP-NET website. Instructor will be able to demonstrate their ability to navigate basic functions. And instructor will be able to implement what they learn to access and print their list of students. So first and foremost, you need to get access to HSP-NET, and this will be granted to you by your academic coordinator or the administrator for your healthcare, if you work in a healthcare environment. And the first time you will be given a username and a temporary password that you need to change. Assuming that all of that has been done, then you will enter your username and your password. Okay, and then you click log in. Once you click log in as an instructor, make sure that your name appears here, right? And your HSP-NET ID will appear as well. Make sure that you keep that confidential. You will see three main tabs: messages, e-orientation, and current placement. Now, because you're an instructor, those are all the three tabs that you might see. Students might see a documentation tab because they need to upload their clinical documents to there. But as an instructor, you don't have to do that. So messages will be any messages that HSP-NET will send you. E-orientation is some institutions, they upload their modules onto the HSP-NET website, but not everybody. And current placement will be the tab that we'll be interested in because that's where your clinical information will be. Now for e-orientation, for those of you who are going to be going to clinical placements, chances are once you reach out to the educator and or the clinical nurse specialist, they will tell you what module to do as part of the orientation, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on our current placements. And you should see a very quick snapshot of your current placements for this semester or the shortly upcoming semester. Now, course here, if you're teaching more than one course, make sure you select the proper code for your course that you want to view. Term here by default is going to show today, which is the date you know that you access HSP-NET. However, you're able to change it to a fall semester, winter, or spring semester accordingly. Okay, so and that can be done through some of the drop down here. Now, if you have any unconfirmed placements, right, then you will click this option here as well. Now, the unconfirmed placements, it's usually, I don't see it very much. And the reason why is because in order to have an unconfirmed placement, there has to be a discussion between you and HSP-NET and also the hospital that is taking you you and your students based on a condition. Okay, so if that's the case, then you would click show unconfirmed placements. Otherwise, just leave it unchecked. Now, back to our main screen here, you will see general information about your placement. The course that you'll be teaching, the type, so it's a group, and the number of students, reference number, you know, and it's confirmed. Usually if there is a green exclamation mark, it's a sign that your placement has been confirmed with the clinical institution. The date, what day you're gonna be there, shift, in this case, I taught a 12 hours day shift. Hours, the amount of hours that you need to teach this semester, 196 for instance, the days that you will be here at the clinical placement. Agency is the name of the hospital or long-term care institution that you're going to be at. The site is, if the hospital has multiple campuses, then it will tell you which campus to go to. Service is the unit that you're going to be going to. And destination is going to be who's the contact person that you have on that site. So what we're going to do is we're going to print the schedule. So we're going to click on print schedule. And you should see two options that shows up, two unchecked options that shows up. Number one says include student contact info. And number two says include shift schedule amendments. So you want to tick on both, because the first option, what it does, it shows your student's name plus their emails for you to reach out to them. Okay. And the second option is to include most recent changes that might have happened in HSP-NET since the last time you logged in. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a check mark in the first option and the second option. As such, once we put the check mark on both these options, we're going to click on our green check mark. Okay, so once we click our green check mark, the next part will be you'll be given a notification that says the instructor schedule has been saved as a PDF file, and in here says instructor schedule. This is a link. Once you click on this link, you will be guided to a PDF file. Okay, and the PDF file, once we click this link, for instance, will look like this. Now, this is the PDF file that you can print and bring with you to clinical, okay, to make sure that your students are correct. And it's a lot of the same information in the main web page that we saw earlier, except that it will show you the student's contact information and some of the comments or limitations that your academic institution has put on or requested, you know, as part of this clinical placement. So we can see the day, the course, instructor, make sure that it matches your name, that you are the one teaching the course, site contacts, the person you'll be contacting, you know, at the hospital or long-term care, the date that you're gonna be there, the group, size, so number of students, the email of the contact person, make sure that this size of students matches also the number of students you have here. So in here, for example, says 4, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and for confidentiality purposes, I have blurred out their name. Now in the comments here, for instance, in this semester, students were not allowed to look after active COVID-19 cases or COVID positive cases, okay? Again, this video was recorded, you know, at the beginning of the fourth wave of the COVID-19 pandemic, so hence these limitations were put on there by the institution. And it leads you to the last part, your student, their name will be here, email, name and email, and then you just use this to email your student and reach out to them. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.